On this edition of Inside Blue Hose Football, Presbyterian College wrapped up the road portion of its schedule at Liberty on Saturday and will return home to face Gardner-Webb in a senior day season finale. We'll talk to head coach Tommy Spangler about how the Blue Hose plan to end the season on a high note, as well as break down the highlights, injury report, coach's corner, and a whole lot more. All that ahead on this edition of Inside Blue Hose Football. Welcome to Inside Blue Hose Football. I'm your host, Ryan Rial, with the head coach of the Blue Hose, Tommy Spangler. Coach, you went up to Liberty for your last road game, and in the past couple weeks, we talked about how well the team has started, how well the first half has gone. This week, not necessarily the case.
Yeah, it was a good night for football. They had a heck of a crowd. Mm-hmm. Of course, they've got an unbelievable facility up there, Ryan, and they were ready to play. Mm-hmm. You know, we talked last week's show about how Liberty was a little bit up and down throughout the year, but I think we got their upside and they were ready to play. We weren't quite as ready out of the gate. I think we settled in and did some good things as the game went, especially on the offensive side of the ball. But overall, disappointed in how we started. I liked the way the guys competed. I think we tried to finish, just was a little bit too little too late.
You look at the offense, like you talked about, Will Brock was able to do some things, score 28 points after, you know, there's two shutout weeks. You're starting to see the offense come to life a little bit, get a couple of rushing touchdowns.
No doubt. But, you know, it was almost like, you know, we got going a little late. Mm-hmm. And I talked to Will after the game and told him how proud I was of him, of his performance. And he said, Coach, I need to play better early. Mm-hmm. And that was a little bit kind of the deal. We got down and got to about 24-7 before we started making a little bit of noise on offense, but it's a team game. Defense didn't play very well. We've got to play better overall special teams. We gave up a big kickoff return on the first kickoff of the game that hurt us, put us in bad field position. Offense showed some signs, but overall consistency isn't what it needs to be. Still looking for that overall really good performance by all three phases.
I think if we told you before the game, you'll win the turnover battle, you won't, you know, no turnovers for your team, time of possession is going to be the same, 5-11 on third down for them, I think you'd take that. But
yeah, but when you look at the tape, we gave up too many big plays on defense. There again, and that crucial to kind of keep it close time of the game, we made some mistakes and didn't execute on both sides like we needed to. I did think second half, we talked about going in at halftime, hey, let's go out, compete, win the second half. I think offense did a heck of a job putting some points on. We took the first drive down and scored and actually, you know, got a fumble there late that could have cut the lead to 42-30 or closer. But we weren't able to get it in.
We talked about those offensive plays. Let's go ahead and look at those with the offensive highlights against Liberty.
Game highlights are brought to you by Matt Davis State Farm Insurance. Like a good neighbor, Matt Davis and State Farm are there.
Ryan, here we go on offense, and we did. We had some big plays this game, probably more explosive plays than we've had all season. You see this clip here. We put Riley in motion. We go some play action. We hit Darquez Watson on a quick slant. He takes it for 58 yards. Darquez probably wishes he had just a little bit more speed there, but heck of a catch in some traffic. Really good ball by Will, throwing it in a window, and then Darquez finding some air and getting going. But these are the kind of plays, you know, you call rack or yak, yards after catch, run after catch. But it's still 58 yards. 58 yards is a big explosive play. Got to set up for a touchdown. Here's Sed Frazier early in the game. It was actually in the first quarter to answer Liberty. We weren't playing very well on defense. They were scoring some points, and we needed something to happen. Something happened good, and here's there again another play action, and Sed gets behind the coverage for a big catch and got us down inside the five for a score. And you can see from this end zone shot, good protection up front. When you got a back like Torrence Marable that you're play faking to, it draws some guys to the line of scrimmage, softens up the coverage a little bit, and there was Sed being able to get behind the safety and a big play. Here's Kyle Goddard. You know, we hadn't talked about Kyle a lot, but he's playing behind Day-Day and is a good player, a transfer to PC from Old Dominion in a year, 2 years ago. And here he is on a 39-yard catch. And there again, a little bit of a play fake off the jet motion. And we find Kyle on the post, and Will laid it up, and he ran under and got it. So, you know, there again, we've talked about 58 yards, 41 yards, 39 yards. That's good to get those kind of explosive plays, and hopefully we can finish it up this week against Gardner-Webb doing the same thing. Here's a big-time fourth and four completion. We're at a point of the game where we needed to go for it in the area of the field where we needed to go for it, and just a really good throw. Norquist stays in bounds, tight ropes the sideline, and gets in for the touchdown. But if you'll notice on this shot here, Will put just enough air under it, Ryan, to kind of get it over the top of the coverage. Laid it in there. Day-Day focused on it, caught it, and got it in the end zone. Here's a big rush by number four, Torrence Marable. You know, the guy had 23 carries for 128 yards, and he continues to just do good things. We've got some good young talent on both sides of the ball. That was a 20-yard carry there. You can see some guys up front pushing some folks around, getting good position, pinning some guys. A little bit of a bounce play there for us off the power G, a good 20-yard gain. And then to wrap it up, here's Mark Robinson, who I think leads our team in scoring. He's kind of that big bruising back when you get down in there close. You can give it to, and he can hammer it up there. And that was a good play. You can see from this shot that we're moving some guys up front, create some holes by our offensive line, and Mark punches it in.
Coach, a lot of great plays there, and your running backs. Torrence Marable had another big game, like you talked about, and Mark Robinson didn't run a ton, but for him, you know, he's had the issues with the fumbles. For him, to punch in the end zone, probably a great day for both.
No doubt, and if you remember last week against Monmouth, had some big runs late in the game and didn't fumble this week, so hopefully he's got his confidence back and has a big game against Gardner-Webb.
To have those two guys, you know, finish the season strong like they're
doing. No doubt, stayed healthy. You know, we've been blessed with about as good a freshman as you can want, and just anxious to see their future.
And the other part of the offense, the receivers, you kind of were able to spread it out. Damian McGee was able to lead the team, and Day-Day had a big game. And, you know,
we had several guys with some big catches. And, you know, like I said, Will threw for almost 300 yards. And, you know, to get 50-yard gains, 40-yard gains, 30-yard gains, that's big. That's something we hadn't had. And we just need to combine that with better defense. And we'll win some football games. So there's some things that are happening that are good. We just got to be more consistent in all phases.
Absolutely. Okay, we're going to take our break, and when we come back, we're going to talk about defensive highlights, the special teams, and the collision of the week. That's when we return to Inside Blue Hose Football.
We're fighting cancer with caring, with technology, with knowledge. And now, with the Hollings Clinical Trial Network at the Medical University of South Carolina. Together, we're bringing more advanced cancer care close to home. Self-Regional Healthcare Cancer Center. We bring advanced care closer.
We'll be right back. As you set your financial game plan, we'll be with you every play. Relax, you're with Founders.
This portion of Inside Blue Hose Football is brought to you by Coca-Cola, taste the feeling. And by Adidas, here to create.
Welcome back to Inside Blue Hose Football. Coach, defensively, you know, you had some plays, you had some playmakers. Certainly Rocky Asin, three pass breakups and two big fumble recoveries.
Sure, and we actually made some plays. I think when you play Liberty, you're either going to have to make some plays or you're going to give up a ton of points. Now, we did a little bit of both. We gave up too many points, but we did make some plays, and it was good to see our guys continuing to improve in some areas. We just got to overall be a little more sounder and get out of the gate a little bit, or get out of the gate a little bit better.
One of the things that, you know, college football is always about looking ahead. You know, you're always talking about recruiting and right. Your freshmen. We talked about the two running backs in the last segment, but we're talking Dirk Kirchen led the team in tackles. Colby Campbell, you know, KJ Presley, a lot of guys on the defensive side of the ball who really stepped up on
Saturday. Yeah, they're in diapers, you know, when it comes to being in this program, you know, and that's what people don't realize is that Grant Bidle on defense, only a couple, Thomas Hughes, Will Brock, only a few, Darquez Watson, a few seniors on offense. So excited about what we want to finish Saturday, but excited about the future of this team.
Absolutely. And let's look at those defensive plays with the defensive highlights against Liberty.
Game highlights are brought to you by Matt Davis State Farm Insurance. Like a good neighbor, Matt Davis and State Farm are there.
Ryan, here we go with some defensive highlights. You know, I'm a defensive guy, and I was a little disappointed in overall how we played on defense. We've actually been playing rather well. This is a good stop, though, early in the game by Michael Branch. You know, Michael's a sophomore, one of our defensive tackles, and comes off a block, makes a good physical tackle in the hole. And I think, you know, down the road, we're going to be really good on the D-line because we're pretty young, of course, losing all the seniors we did last year. Here's another sophomore. Getting ready to get in on this solo tackle. This is Eli Turner, who actually knifed through and made a really good stop. The official spotted it to a first down, but you can see on the behind the shot scene here that it actually wasn't that big of a gain, and he knocked him back, and that's a pretty good tackle there by a free safety that doesn't weigh a lot. Here's a really good play by Brian Washington and Eli Turner on the corner. And you can see that they're trying to get outside, pitch it to them. There's Brian, there's Eli rallying to the ball. We did some good things on defense, not consistent enough, and obviously gave up too many points. Here's a true freshman, Colby Campbell, out of South Aiken High School, knifing through, kind of sniffing out the zone play there by Liberty. They had a couple good backs. That Mosley kid right there, 34, is a good player. You can see we're still having a hard time getting him to the ground, but a really good play by Colby. I thought this was one of the best plays of the game. It looked like for sure it was going to be a completion. They had a lot of air on Ryan Burgess. You can see him up top, the second guy in. Play action pass that got us kind of biting up a little bit. And, you know, when you put a safety with a free release by the number two receiver, that's hard to defend, but he speed turns, he rolls through, and he gets it out right there. Heck of a play by Ryan Burgess, who's been in our program. He's still got another year. You know, we only lose one guy, Ryan, on defense, and that's number 10 you see in the screen right there, Grant Bidle, who is obviously a pretty productive player for us. But, you know, really, really a good play here by Ryan that hopefully we can continue to build on and minimize a few points. And then finally, here's that number two guy, kind of like number four on offense, is number two on defense. He leads the league in interceptions. He actually had two fumble recoveries on Saturday. Rock Yassin with the, you know, quarterback had a little bit more time than I'd like, but Rock did a nice job there on a deep ball down the field, getting his hand on it. And, you know, a lot of times it's not exactly how you start, it's how you finish. And, you know, Rock wasn't in the most perfect of positions early, but he's fast enough, he's speedy enough and he's determined enough to get back here and make a play.
Rocky Assembly, we talked about him. I think he might be in contention for some awards later on in the season. All right, now let's take a look at the special teams highlights with the special teams against Liberty.
You know, Ryan, on special teams, I thought we did some good things. We kind of a hot and cold night. We gave up a big kickoff return, but I thought in some other phases of the game, we did some good things. Here's the Keith Pearson, another true freshman that's hits one back for 37 yards. Just does a good job. Picks up a couple good blocks here. You can see on this shot here that our guys have worked hard on kickoff return, and it's not easy. You know, when you got guys screaming down the field 100 miles an hour on top of you, it's not easy to sustain blocks and make blocks, but that's a good run by Keith for 37 yards. Here's Brett Norton, who had a pretty good night punting. You know, he's been fairly consistent all year. I think he's second in the league in punting. Nice 46-yarder that hangs up there and gives our guys time to get down the field. And, of course, when you kind of combine the distance with the hang time, that gives guys a chance to cover, thus forcing a fair catch by Liberty. That's a good kick by Brett. Here's another punt. We're pinned down. I don't like to see us quite pinned down like this, but we're pinned down. We got to protect. We got to get it out. He gets it out. This is, there again, another true freshman, Dirk Curitan. We've talked about Dirk. He's been starting for us at corner for Kenny Coleman, who's hurt. And Dirk's also been on kickoff. He's been on kickoff return. He's been on punt. Mm-hmm. He's been on punt return. The guy's doing a lot. And there's a good tackle, open field tackle by Dirk Curitan. Really proud of him. And here's a extra point. You know, sometimes these, you know, they I guess it got boring in the NFL. You know, they moved it right back, and that might happen eventually for us. We actually got a penalty right here on Liberty, and we took the penalty to get even closer to help us with the angle. But this is a good job, good snap by Cooper Short, a true freshman, good protection up front, and Brett knocks it through. And then this last clip is a block field goal. That's several block kicks we got now this year, Ryan, and we've been pretty good at it. This is Jaycee Yeldell getting his hand up and deflecting the ball, and there again preventing some points. And, you know, kind of, you know, it's never over until it's up in light, so to speak. Right. And that's why our guys kept battling. And right there, the game wasn't very close.
You see Jaycee Yeldell with the ball blocking it. Kind of a collision, but we've got a different one in mind with our collision of the week.
Collision of the Week is brought to you by Hanna Heating and Air.
Hey, this week's Collision of the Week is KJ Presley, another freshman. Okay, I keep saying that word a lot. It's kind of scary, but he gets penetration here, and this is late. We kicked off, and, you know, makes a good play in the backfield. You can see Rock pick it up, scoop. Rock tries to stay in, but just barely. Steps out of bounds, tries to get the ball inside the pylon. But, you know, good penetration by KJ up front and kind of knocking the ball loose, and the ball's on the ground. And, you know, before you know it, I kind of got blocked from the view right there, and there's Rock picking it up and taking it back. But, unfortunately, I don't even think we got this ball in there, but good play.
There's one of those freshmen we talked about, and we're going to talk about the seniors with this week's Senior Day and our next week's preview against Gardner-Webb, as well as our Coach's Corner and Palmetto and Bonin Joint Injury Report. That's when we return to Inside Blue Hose Football.
I'm a random windstorm. Shaky, 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 shaky. Shaky, shaky. And if you got cut-rate insurance, you could be picking up this tab yourself. So get Allstate. You could save some cash and be better protected from mayhem like me.
Honey, what are you doing?
Watching a cow. Impressions.
Power up your morning with a new 300-calorie egg white grill.
only at Chick-fil-A.
Tailgating is a song heard from Alabama to the Carolinas and everywhere in between. They say this song can be heard elsewhere, and perhaps this is true, but it is nowhere near as bright, nowhere near as loud, nowhere near as triumphant as it is in the South. Tailgating may not have been born here, but here is where tailgaters are born.
If you're considering joint replacement surgery, ask yourself these questions. Is my orthopedic surgeon experienced in joint replacement? Does he listen to my concerns? Explain all my options? Will he manage my pain? Will he help me regain the active life I want? The orthopedic surgeons of Palmetto Bone and Joint are proud members of Newberry Hospital's award-winning joint replacement team. We're among the best in the state and nation for hip and knee replacement. You have a choice. Palmetto Bone and Joint.
This portion of Inside Blue Hose Football is brought to you by Hannah Heating and Air, Nichols Automotive, and by Printers Associates.
Welcome back to Inside Blue Hose Football. And I feel like we've talked about the offense a lot on today's show. Let's keep it rolling with offensive coordinator Todd Varn in this week's Coach's Corner.
Coach's Corner is brought to you by Jeff Smith, Allstate Insurance of Clinton. You're in good hands with Allstate and Jeff Smith.
Welcome to this week's edition of Coach's Corner. I'm Todd Varn, offensive coordinator here at Presbyterian College. This week, we're going to be looking at one of our first third down conversions we had against Liberty. And this was a big part of the game, trying to get in the flow and getting some first downs and trying to get to the end zone and score here. So what we did is we reduced a formation out of trips. Okay, we have a tight end nub on the backside instead of a wide receiver. And then we clustered our three receivers, which is the trip side over here to the field. So we could try to get some mismatches on zone coverage over here to the strength. So it's a curl concept, which we tag one of the receivers that he's responsible for being the midpoint of the curl, which is over the center. Okay, so we tag the Z. So Z pushes inside all the way over the ball. That tells the Y, who's expanding now, okay, so he's trying to widen the defense. He's got the curl, so he widens the curl. In the third leg of the triangle here, he's running the flat route, and the quarterback has the option to read this side. Now, on the back side, we have a cover two throw, which the tight end's running a corner route, and the back would run a flat. So he decided to go to the field throw, which is basically a quarters look. So he's keeping his eyes toward the tight end, trying to widen the mic, and he's reading the triangle, which we say the triangle here. So he's reading over the ball to the curl to the flat. He moved the linebacker enough. He stepped up. We had protection here. They even ran a twist, and we picked it up. And Brock did a good job of getting off on time, a good timing route here. I think this was Darquez that caught this, or maybe Day-Day. And got the first down. I think we drove down and scored. So this was really big at this point. And everybody did a great job of executing what we had practiced. So wish we could have, put a few more on the board. We missed some opportunities there. But this was a big one at the time, and they did a good job of executing.
Next week's preview is brought to you by The Bud Group. Great people, smart service.
It was great to see and appreciate offensive coordinator Todd Varn taking time out to talk to us for Coach's Corner. All right, coaches, this is the last game of the season, last time we have to do this. What's the health of the Blue Hose with their Palmetto Bone and Joint injury report?
There was a time the other night that I thought, oh my goodness, did we bring enough guys? Because we were falling pretty quick. Elijah Turner went out with a concussion. Seth Frazier out with a concussion. Jarius Duncan went out with it, broke his tibia. So we had Will Brock ended up, who's may or may not be playing this weekend. Okay. So it wasn't a good week for the Blue Hose all the way around. Plus we had a 5-hour bus ride on top of that. So, hopefully, but we're blessed and we're going to keep keep working, and hopefully we'll stay healthy this week.
Okay. And you have a big game this week, Senior Day season finale against Gardner-Webb. And every time we've talked about Gardner-Webb throughout the season, it's always been they're the best, whatever record they are. They're entering 1-9, but a brutal schedule, and they put up some very good results against
good teams.
I think
our schedule and theirs has got to be the toughest in FCS. Mm-hmm. And kind of like us, you know, they've had games where they've competed very, very, very well. There's only been a couple games where they've somewhat have been blown out a little bit, but very two similar teams. They've got the preseason player of the year in Terrell Maxwell at quarterback, and they're good on defense. We've had trouble with them. We beat them a couple years ago, but that's the only time we beat them. So this will be a challenge.
And I feel like every game going back, you know, I've been at with Gardner-Webb PC, it's always a rock fight. It's always like in the trenches, you know, whoever makes a mistake, whoever
it
blinks.
It is. It's always somewhat low scoring. We probably allowed too many last year, but up until last year, always a real low scoring. We had to beat them up there 1 year 14-7 and block a field goal for touchdown to help win the game. So very, very, very good opponent. You can forget the record. Neither team likes each other. It's kind of one of those deals. We go back to the sack days, and we've played along, you know, played each other. They don't like us. We don't like them, all that, and it's all in good, but it's PC Gardner-Webb.
And last game for some very important players this
game. No doubt.
It's a senior day. Be there this Saturday, 1 o'clock in Gardner-Webb. Well, for the head coach, Tommy Spangler, I'm Ryan Real, and I just want to say how great this season has been to spend it with you. I really appreciate you tuning in. Coach, appreciate you,
Ryan.
Spending your time with
awesome.
Us.
It's been awesome.
For everything that PC has gone through this year, you can see the improvement and just a great group of guys.
Sure. So, appreciate you.
Can't wait to say goodbye to some of those guys on Saturday and then look forward to next year. That's this Saturday against Gardner-Webb. For all of us here at Inside Blue Hose Football, we'll see you next season for Inside Blue Hose Football.
Inside Blue Hose Football was brought to you by Founders Federal Credit Union. Relax, you're with Founders. And by Self Regional Healthcare.